Hey guys, this is Argil here, and I'm back with your little updatey video. Last month was definitely not my month, you guys know that, but I do want to get back into the swing of things and make videos regularly again. Ideally, I want to make update videos, like general update videos, every week. Hopefully I'll have enough stuff to update on. but also, of course, I want to make more character videos and really explain to you guys more about my characters and dolls and their worlds and all that good stuff. Last month was just really difficult, but I am trying to get back in the swing of things and making lots of videos for you guys, so hopefully you guys are excited. But this is just going to be my usual rambly, just sort of updatey, blah blah blah, telling you guys things video. Although I did have a few updates that I just decided I would just make and do separate videos. Weirdly enough, I'm actually recording my update video before the other videos. I usually do it update video first and the rest of the detail stuff later, but this is a weird day. so, yes, I'm going to be making, I think, at least two more videos explaining some other changes and thoughts and just developments that have happened. But this is going to be just sort of like a just general update video. Just thoughts and feelings and stuff that I've received and gotten and changed and made and all that good stuff. But I will also say that I'm doing one thing differently in this video as well, and that is that I am not recording my voice at the same time that I'm recording the actual video. It's hard to explain, but usually like I'll say like, oh, in the video with me I have Euclid or Raum or River, like I have them in the video with me so I can explain who they are, but this time I'm actually recording the audio separately, just casually at my desk because I feel that's more natural for me. So I can't tell you exactly who is in the video right now because I don't know who I'm going to end up putting in the video. I might just end up editing a picture in or multiple pictures, or I might just record a little snippet of one of my dolls and then loop it. it's not really going to change anything in the course of the video, but I thought I'd let you guys know just testing something out and seeing how it works. Of course, whatever doll I put in the video, I will either tell you what they are on the side of the video, the layouts, or I will, of course, as always, put it in the description. So, I think I'll probably end up putting Raum in the video, because he's had some stuff, he's had some awesome stuff done, so I will explain that in a minute, but yes. Anyway, by the way, guys, thank you so very much for all of your kind words and support for me last month. The passing of my father and all that stuff. I really, really appreciate all of her kindness and being patient with me, of course. Of course, right when I start commissions, right? When it rains, it pours. I have to deal with sad things. But commissions have been amazing, by the way. You guys are so awesome. I love painting your dolls. It's so much fun. I love it. I have the best job ever. It's so great. I got to paint. I'm actually working on it right now. I just have to brag because it's so awesome. I'm actually getting the amazing opportunity to paint a doll that I've wanted to see in real life and really, really want. it's a Fairyland Minifee Luka. I've wanted to see this sculpt in real life and have considered getting one of my own in the future a lot, so it's so nice to actually see them in person. It's so cool, so the person that sent me them, thank you so much for allowing me the pleasure. They're super awesome. And they're in tan as well. It's amazing. I'll show you on Flickr when I'm finished with them. But anyway, I'm rambling. Thank you guys so much for commissioning me. That's all I'm saying. I love painting your guys' dolls. It's so much fun. I feel like I'm getting a lot better too. So that's always a plus. So anyway, as far as updates are concerned, I actually, like I said, I have done quite a lot of things for Raum, who is my Soom Appini / Argil in bronze skin. My cute little Egyptian kitty. I have actually been working on making him Egyptian jewelry, if you can believe that, and also working on painting his wings and ears. If you guys follow me on Flickr, and I think I mentioned it in my previous video, I can't remember. It's been a while. but I painted his ears, and I was a little apprehensive about them. I wasn't exactly sure if I was really feeling the way that I painted them, since they're rather stylistic. So I asked for your guys' opinions and what you thought, and you guys were super helpful and told me that I should probably wait to decide until I had also painted his wings similarly, because that would really help me, get a feel for cohesion and see if I like them all together. So I had painted his ears, and if you want to see a picture of that, again, I will link you to my Flickr. They're rather stylistic and really, really cool, but I'm just a little not sure if it's right yet, you know? But I'm also working on painting his wings now. I had to postpone it a while because I'm busy with face-ups and I've just been busy in general and all the drama that happened with my real feed May, but I'll get to that in a minute. It's just been hard to work on stuff for myself, but slowly but surely I've been working on his wings and making things for him when I have a little bit of time. I will definitely go ahead and show you guys once he, hopefully in the video, if he's finished, then I will show you him. But if not, hopefully I will take pictures soon and show you guys all of these things I'm going to mention, and with his wings and all that good stuff too. I made him some super awesome little Egyptian jewelry things. They're so cool. The first of which is like a beaded Egyptian style necklace, like a collar thing. It's hard to explain in words, but hopefully I'll have pictures, like I said, or I will post them soon. But I've wanted to make him like a fancy Egyptian collar forever, and I just finally went ahead and did it. Luckily, my mom, she loves like making human jewelry. She loves beading. So she has lots and lots of beads laying around, and she was kind enough to let me have some of them, some of the smaller ones anyway, since Rom is a USD. It's hard to find beads that are small enough for him, but I think it worked out very, very well. I'm so happy. It looks really good. I'm surprised. I did not think it would turn out as good as it did, and I can't wait to make one for River as well, I just snapped a rubber band, to make a few more in the future as well, because they're so much fun to make and they're so awesome. I will show you guys that as soon as I can. I also made him little bracelets, like thick bangles, I guess, out of epoxy. They're gold and black. They're super, super cool. I also made those for him. Oh, like I said, hopefully I'll show you all this stuff. It's really, really cool. But the coolest thing that I actually ended up making for him is like a mantle? I don't know how to explain it. It's like a piece of like gold metal, but it's actually like epoxy, of course, but canonically what it's supposed to be is like this super intricate fancy piece of gold that is like embellished all like Egyptian style, and it sort of like has a little collar around his neck, and then it also sort of drapes along his back and over the caps of his shoulders. It's really, really cool. It's actually what he canonically wears in his story. It's not like super traditional Egyptian, like the other necklace I made for him is much more traditional, but his story, his and River's story, of course, is like a fantasy version of ancient Egypt. It's not like a historically accurate version. It's like my own interpretation. So the way they dress is a little bit different. It's not super like exactly what you see on cave paintings, if you will. But yes, yeah, so that little like mantle thing is more accurate to what he actually wears in the story. And I wanted to try and recreate it for the longest time, and I'm glad that I finally did and that it came out surprisingly well. I'm very, very happy with it. I really like sculpting in epoxy. I don't know, it's just, I don't know, I like it a lot. It's really easy to carve into sand, but it's also very hard and durable. It's a really cool material. I was always used to sculpting things with polymer clay, like Fimo and Sculpey, and I hate it. I know a lot of people love to sculpt with polymer clay, but I hate it so much. It's so sticky and gooey, and it's hard to get it to have any substance, and it's really difficult to sand and carve. I'm not a big fan of it, to be honest. It's good for certain things. Like, I make all of my unicorn horns out of it, and also making flowers for my little flower crowns. That, for those things, it's very, very great. But for sculpting, like, weapons and armor and that kind of stuff, I think epoxy is definitely what I much, much prefer. And I've wanted to, that leads me into what I'm explaining, I've wanted to make armor and props and stuff like that for my dolls for a very long time, since a lot of them actually wear a lot of intricate, fancy pieces like that. And this was a really good test to see whether or not I could do it and whether or not I had any competency in it. And I definitely think that I want to practice it more in the future, because I think it came out very well, what I made for Rom, and I'm very, very happy. I'm like, yes, I have potential, I think. So hopefully you guys will like it. I think it's really, really, really cool, and I'm very, very excited. it's so cool to see him, like, come together, like, canonically, and I just love everything to do with ancient Egypt, by the way. So it's so cool to actually, like, be able to make some of this stuff and finally see him, like, looking actually Egyptian. It's so cool. For those of you guys who don't know, when I was a child, I wanted to be an Egyptologist, because I love ancient Egypt so much. Everything to do with Egyptian history is fascinating to me. However, I realized very soon after that I hate the heat and I hate the desert, so that didn't work out very well. But I still love everything to do with Egypt. It's just fascinating and beautiful culture to me. Ancient Egypt, of course. Anyway, so I will show you guys the cool things that I've made for Raum, hopefully sometime soon. Other updates that I have, minor updates, but I have received the dress that I was waiting for Euclid, and also for my real fiancé, Maro, Bettina Maro. I have received them, and I will hopefully show you guys them soon, or make another video showing them off, because they're so amazing, I love them so much. I won't get too much into it now, because I feel like I'll ramble more than I already have. But I will show you guys those soon, or take pictures of them. Hopefully both. They're so awesome. I can't wait to show you guys. I also received Euclid's fancy shoes as well, which I will also show you in the future. But other little updates that I have, I've made another video explaining all about this, so I don't want to give too much of it away. But I have plans. Let's just leave it at that. I have plans in mind. I am saving up for something that is going to be released soon in the future, and it is by Fairyland. For those of you guys who have seen Fairyland's most recent post on their blog, you guys will know exactly what I mean, and I am saving for it. And I have made a separate video explaining all about it, but yes, so I am saving up for that event because I can't miss it. I'm so pumped. You guys have no idea. If you thought I was pumped for the Real Fee event, I am like super pumped. I am like super Saiyan for this event right now. Don't get in my way, dude. Fight me, man. I'm being silly. But anyway, I'm saving up money for that event, and that means that I also am selling a few things as well. Not anything major, just a few eyes that I have that I don't use, as well as Bettina Morrow's human legs, since I never use those either. I might also sell a few pieces of clothing and also some wigs in the future. I have to sort of go through my stuff and sort of figure it out. And I've also decided that I want to transition all of my dolls into alpaca wigs, or more, what's the word? Just different types of, like, fibers in the future. I'm kind of moving out of the whole synthetic and fur wig category and moving into making my own things, because I love making my own things. Everything that I can make on my own, I probably will. And I love the way that alpaca fiber feels and looks, and the fact that you can dye it any color you want is amazing. So I really don't have much use for synthetic wigs much anymore, so I will probably be getting rid of some of those as well. But yeah, so I am going to be selling a few things. I might list it on my Flickr. I don't know. I hate advertising, like, on my channel and Flickr. I don't know. It feels gross to me. But just letting you guys know, if you see anything for sale from me, I'm saving. I cannot miss this. I have been saving, of course, on my own, but I feel like I'll need a little bit more. Anyway, so yes, selling a few things. The other update that I have, of course, I have mentioned. I have mentioned all about this on Flickr, so if you guys don't know, I will link you to my Flickr, and it explains it much better. I don't really want to get into it here, the whole story of it, but it is concerning my Fairyland Littlefee May, Bettina Maro. I have had the most difficult time with this doll. She has been nothing but problems ever since she has arrived, which is depressing because I was so inspired by her, and and also, sadly enough, is that I wanted to draw so many pictures of her too, but then I just felt so uninspired by my art, and it's been a hard time for me. Anyway, yes, but I had a lot of issues with Bettina Maro, my Fairyland Littlefee May in mint. Of course, you guys know that originally when she was shipped out, she was sent with the wrong faceplate. They sent her with Pano instead of May, and that was okay. Like, I was perfectly fine with that. That was all right. Like, mistakes happen. That's, you know, understandable. But then once I finally got her May faceplate, once Fairyland finally sent it, she had a whole load of other problems. Again, I'm not going to get into the whole thing. If you want to read it, I will link you to the post where I explain everything that's wrong and pictures and all that good stuff. But essentially what the problems were is that her faceplate, it would not connect to the head back whatsoever. It literally could not stay attached. It would just fall off immediately. It was impossible for it to be used as it was. And she also had scratches on both sides of her face, as well as a really weird, like, resin flaw sort of pock mark on the top of her head. And it was really, really, really devastating and concerning because the pano faceplate was perfect. So why is the one that I ordered not? It was just, I don't want to explain it because I keep breaking rubber bands. I've already explained it, so again, I will link you to that on Flickr. But long story short, Fairyland did actually help me in the long run. DDE transferred over my concerns that I shared to them over to Fairyland, and Fairyland did offer to help me with her faceplate not fitting. They gave me a solution to make it fit, which actually did end up working after a little bit of trial and error. And they also offered, if I didn't feel comfortable with fixing it the way they recommended, that they would also accept to take her back and fix it themselves. But it would take quite a while, of course, at least a month. So in the interest of saving time, I decided to go ahead and do it myself, which was essentially boiling the faceplate. Which didn't work, by the way. I had to boil the head back, and then it worked. You guys probably know that boiling resin, it makes it a bit more malleable, so you can change it around and move fingers and such. I had never thought to do it to fix faceplates, but it actually did end up working once I figured out what to do. And so I'm very, very, very thankful they shared that, and they did offer to do it themselves if I was not capable of doing it. So her face finally fits. She's all put together now. Finally, I can see her cute little adorable face, which I love so much. The May sculpt is definitely my second favorite Fairyland sculpt, right after Luka, of course. I love the sculpt so much. It's freaking adorable. I'd love to have another one in the future. But yes, she's all put together now. Unfortunately, Fairyland didn't offer to fix the scratches she has on the side of her face, and that really, really sucks. But at the very least, they did offer to fix the fit issue, and I do really appreciate that, because I didn't think they would help whatsoever. So yeah, I have already went ahead and sanded her scratches on her face, because luckily I am actually capable of doing that myself, and I did actually intend to sand her seams too. So it's not the worst thing in the world. It's very unfortunate I had to deal with that, and I shouldn't have to, but I am thankful at least that Fairyland did at least attempt to help. Yeah, so I'm very, very thankful in that regard. I restored my faith in them a little bit, so yes, but I'm very, very, very happy to have her put together. She's so, so cute. I can't wait to show you guys her. Hopefully I'll make a video showing you her adorable little dress. And she's wearing a temporary wig right now, but also I've made her unicorn horn as well. I can't wait to show you guys her. If she's not in the video already, I don't know who I put in this video. But I love her so much, and I'm so glad that these problems are getting fixed, because for a while there, I didn't want to look at her at all. I was like, I'm done with you. Go away. But I'm so glad that I got over it and that she's getting fixed, because I love her so much. And she's really giving me that feeling that I felt when I first saw her and I first started planning out her character and designing her and all that good stuff. So I should say, like, when I first started perfecting her design, because she already existed before, but you know what I mean. You guys remember. So yes. Anyway, again, if you want to hear all the stuff that happened and the whole thing, I will link you to Flickr, but I'm glad I didn't make another video. Like, I plan to make another video just going over all of the things that happened when I received her and every problem that she had and all that stuff, and, like, you know, voice my concerns and my legitimate concerns, by the way. I'm not making things up. Like, she had legitimate problems. But I'm glad I didn't, because I feel like it wouldn't have been a very, like, positive video, and I like to make positive videos. But long story short, she's coming together. She's improving day by day, and she's getting fixed, and she's coming together, and I'm very, very happy with that. So, yes. Anyways, thank you guys so, so very much for watching. I have quite a few more videos to make. This video got way longer than I wanted it to. But hopefully you guys don't mind. And as always, thank you guys so, so, so very much for watching. And I have many more. So many more. Just a handful of videos just waiting to fall from the sky and into the computer.